Maranatha Christian Church is present in nations of all the continents of this planet. We have churches in the three Americas, Europe, Africa, Asia, and Oceania, connected by the same doctrine with the direction of the Holy Spirit of God, united by the living word. Brethren from all parts of the world participate in the same service together, in the same body, and in the same spirit. Through the system that we have of transmission, members from the Church Maranatha from all of the world live a moment of fellowship, just like the Hebrews lived when they left Egypt, and just like the disciples lived with Jesus when he was going to die on the cross. People from all parts of the world have been reached by this eternal gospel and of the message of the soon return of the Lord. Brethren, peace of the Lord Jesus, we are beginning our Sunday school this morning from our Central of Communication Central in the city of Vila Velha in Brazil. We have with us today some pastors and some other family members, and we are very happy to be receiving these pastors. We have Pastor José Martins, and his wife is here as well. He's from Portugal. He's visiting us here in Brazil. We have Pastor Anchieta with us. Now, Pastor Daniel. We have some announcements. First is a service that we had in a boat in France, Paris, France. There was a seminar with some pastors from Ghana, multiple pastors of ours were united in this church for this seminar. There was also a service in the Democratic Republic of the Congo in Africa, and they have been watching the Sunday school transmissions along with us, which is very important to us. We've had some baptisms in Utah, also in California. We had a baptism there as well. There have been some events also occurring in the Church of Winnipeg in Canada. In Brazil, we've had a seminar for the youth in Brasilia. There was a special service in our church in Fundão in Espírito Santo. There was also a special service with a Lord's Supper in Rio de Janeiro. We've had anniversaries of churches in various parts of Brazil, various special services as well in the city of Maceió. There was also an honoring done for the people in Colatina. There was a youth seminar as well in Paraná. There was also a training done in the Manaim do Paraíba. The teaching project that we have in Brazil was also completed in Rio de Janeiro in one of our churches there. Also in churches in Goiânia. We've had vigils with our youth in Governador Valadares in Minas Gerais and also in the city of Sobradinho. There were various evangelizations in Rio Grande do Sul and Rio. In Cabo Frio and Rio as well. There were various locations in Rio that they've had evangelisms in. Evangelizations. In these cities as well, multiple other cities, there have been evangelizations, preaching the good word of the Lord and his soon return. There were other baptisms in various parts of Brazil, in Paraíba, Belo Horizonte, Minas Gerais, other cities in Minas Gerais, in Bahia, all different cities. Minas Gerais, São Paulo, all have had baptisms within this last week. Last week, we also transmitted this information for the project that we have, that we are starting to assist children with deficiencies. We are recording classes that are in sign language for those who are hard of hearing or deaf. And we are also making material in Braille for those who are blind. And this is the website that we can use to access the information. It is up on the screen. We are making a songbook for those who are blind in Braille, so they could follow along and sing with us. We'd also like to advise that our church, Maranatha Christian Church, is publicating official information on all of these different social medias, on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram. And we want to just inform that we are using these social media sites as seriously as possible. Any inappropriate posts and comments will be taken down. Maranatha Christian Church is present in social media. We have an official YouTube channel where we have transmissions of events and special services, messages. We have also an official page on Facebook and Instagram. Their ads are on the screen, Igreja Cristã Maranatha. Our presence in these social medias are there so we can promote the word of the Lord and spread the information and the message of that our church is trying to, and that the word tries to give of the return of the Lord. And it is only in these, in on these social media handles that you're going to see official information directly from the church. Now we're going to introduce a new animation for a children's song that we have been showing every week, and this one is the new one for this week. Amen. Glory to God. Brethren, now our children, intermediates, adolescents can be released to go receive the Sunday school teaching for them this morning. While the children are walking to the classes, we're going to give one more presentation for a new song animation that we have for the children, and we're going to start doing this every week, giving new animations for children's songs. Glory to God. Brethren, now we're going to be commencing our Sunday school teaching for today. we're going to be giving a topic about the ministry, and this topic is for the purpose to give the pastoral characteristics of the ministry of the Lord. And the word is in Isaiah. And what we're going to be using as an example for us today is the ministry that is given an example in Isaiah. And it is in the book of Isaiah, chapter 6, verses 1 through 6 that we're going to be reading. Very well, brethren, peace of the Lord. In first place, we'd like to say that we are trying to perfect, we're in the path of perfecting our ministry. We're trying to improve our government of the church, the ministry, our church in general, and especially in relation to evangelizations. The work that we have been doing so far with Sunday schools have been showing great results and reaping great benefits for us. And we will always want to be preparing ourselves to get better. And today, it's very important to understand that the ministry has to be very well integrated with doctrine. And every religious group, there is a system of doctrines and rules that they have to follow. Their own denomination can have their very own rules, but we know that we're not stuck to these norms. Maranatha Christian Church, there's no problem in setting these rules, but we must understand that the project doesn't belong to us. It's the Lord's. We are only worried about this project. And a project doesn't exist without those in charge to lead this project. So those who are called to lead, this is the ministry of the church. When we speak of the work, we are speaking of the work of the Holy Spirit. So if the work is of the Holy Spirit, there is only room for the Holy Spirit in the work. We are in a period right now of transition. We've had 50 years of church. We've had many difficulties. We've had many battles. The past have given us lots of lessons that we can learn from. And there have been many good things that we are keeping, but also many things that are unnecessary that we are getting rid of. So the topic today is to show our workers and our deacons and our pastors that the ministry of this work is not what the pastor thinks should be done, is not what us as humans in our eyes think that should happen. This doesn't exist. We have a system that only the Holy Spirit has room to work. The pulpit is a place for revelation, not a place where man comes up and speaks freely. It's a place where the Lord is going to speaking through them. The word of the Lord says when Peter was called to represent the body of Christ through the Holy Spirit, within the Holy Spirit. And that's why we have the gifts of the Holy Spirit. And we have to understand what these gifts are. And these gifts are important because they are what bring us closer to God.
Ela está lutando independente com relação ao projeto reino, com relação ao arrebatamento. Ela não
the church has to be separated from this world. We are here with the purpose of obtaining salvation. This is the understanding that the Lord has given us to present today, because we have to present a work of the Lord that is only has room and is only guided by the Holy Spirit. There's no reason for me to get up on the pulpit and start making all these gestures and dancing around up here. That's not necessary. Making it a theater up on the pulpit. We are trying to show our brethren the necessity for us to be humble and for us to let the Lord lead and do His work. We don't need extraordinary men up here. What is the most important is what we say that comes from the Holy Spirit, the revelation of the Lord. The rest, theater, trying to show off and make themselves big on the pulpit for their own honor is not what we're here for. We know what is tradition. Tradition is something that happens every day is the same thing, and it's not like this either. The work of the Lord is whatever the Holy Spirit wants us to do. We're going to be reminded of an important aspect. The songs, the praise that the brethren listen to. What happens in the churches if the pastor has one or two instrumentalists and they don't have the correct position to be playing this? It's better for you to sing a song without any instruments, get it right without anything first to it, then add instruments later. If a church doesn't even have any instruments, you don't have to cry about not having instruments. The Lord is going to provide later down the road, instrumentalists that are capable. The songbook that we have speaks of the history of the church. Everything that we stand for are these songs. We cannot take them. We cannot sing them lightly. And we're not against songs that are made by other people. It doesn't matter if they're spiritual or not, but our worry is to show that what we say, what we sing, is what we live, is what we are living every day. It's what I always say. I can sing a song from Paraguay, but I'm from Brazil. The song, the national anthems from United States, United Kingdom, they're beautiful, but I am a resident of Brazil. I'm a native of Brazil. We have to sing and live what we have to preach, what we live, sing what we go through every day. In Brazil, I sing the Brazilian national anthem because I'm singing what I know, my experiences. I'm not going to sing another country's national anthem, and it's in the same way that it should happen in the church. For us, what is important is to understand what comes from the Holy Spirit. We are a ministry. We are not worried about any other ministry of other churches. We're worried about those who have dedicated their lives and are aware of what the Holy Spirit wants them to do. And when this ministry is gonna fail, when we don't listen to the Holy Spirit, when we go on and do what the flesh wants. there was one time where a church was doing a Lord's Supper, but they didn't have any of the bread or the wine necessary to do the supper. They didn't have the government in the church and the leaders there to be able to lead them and to do it correctly. There wasn't any dialogue. There wasn't any communication. Everyone showed up and there was nothing there. There was something wrong. And that's something that the ministry has to take care of. And this type of stuff is not going to be permitted in our ministries, in our governments. The church cannot suffer because of the mistakes of others. We cannot mimic those who do something wrong either. If a church starts doing something wrong, starts making too many mistakes, pretty soon they're going to be totally out of the control of the Holy Spirit, totally led by something that is not the will of the Lord. And while we are here on this earth, we have to continue to strive to get better and to be better so we can preach the word of the Lord and the message of his return. Because this is what we're here for. And we have to each and every day strive to do this better and better. And we are here today to speak of this and how to perfect our ministries. We know that many of us are tired. We have long and busy weeks. The high priest, Eli, he lost his ministry. He wasn't doing things right. The Lord took it away from him. But in order for this sad thing to happen, as a result, the work was able to stand and stay. We want a government, a ministry that works. If we have to take away a few leaders that are doing this wrong in order to do it correctly, in order for the work to flow, then so be it. A fundamental detail that I want everyone to listen to. Next Sunday, we're going to have satellite on at 8 o'clock in the morning. And the first class, I want every single church of Brazil and the whole world to be watching the seminar that we're going to have next week. I want everyone to be on and watching the class that we're going to have at 8 o'clock. We're going to have next Sunday is going to be dedicated for the seminar. We're going to be watching the classes together, and I want everyone to participate as best they can. And I want to also give a warning for everyone to be careful, not to give too many kisses or too many hugs, especially from people who are coming from other countries. We know of the virus and everything that is going around. Reminding people to wash their hands, not to touch their faces if their hands are dirty. But now that we've got that out of the way, we're talking about the physical cleaning. Let's talk about the spiritual cleaning of our souls. So today, we consulted so that this topic could have been brought for the Sunday school. And this is a very important topic to us that we want to make sure everyone understands fully. And if we, if there are some workers, deacons, something is happening in the lives of our servants who are leaders and have functions in church, we're just asking that if there's something of great difficulty, if something's happening that you physically makes you not be able to complete the work of the Lord to the best of your abilities, ask for an excuse. Ask for a break. You don't have to lead when you're not in the physical or mental or spiritual condition to. Talk to your pastors about that. We want to make sure our ministries and our government and our churches are working to the best of their abilities. And this is something we're not gonna be mad about. We're gonna give the word to pastor now. I ask the brethren to open their Bibles now into Isaiah chapter 6. And the first question that we have is, read the text in Isaiah 6, 1, 6, and identify. I'm going to repeat that one more time. Read the text in Isaiah 6, 1, 6. And in order, identify the three fundamental characteristics of a responsible ministry. So in the order that they show up in the verses, identify the three fundamental characteristics of a responsible ministry. There's two or three fundamental characteristics that is stated in chapter 6 of Isaiah, and we want to talk about and identify the two or three that characterizes a ministry as responsible. And we're going to give something to help the brethren. The word fear in verse 1. Why is this a fundamental characteristic? Because in verse 1, Isaiah feared the Lord. What happened there with prophet Isaiah in the first verse that relates fear as one of the fundamental characteristics? So let's read here together the verse. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lifted up, and the train of his robe filled the temple. And the characteristic that states that this is a responsible ministry, this is our job in this moment, is to identify this. The brethren may be seeking the answer. There was a death. Someone had to die. And who was the one who died? The king. The king dies. And the servant sees the throne. Here in this first verse, we see the fear. Because when it speaks of the death of King Uzziah, this death was necessary for the prophet to see the Lord sitting on the throne. The answer of the brethren, and in his answer, he says exactly what identified the fear in this verse. The king in this verse, he dies. King Uzziah dies. And from this moment on, he has new values, new morals, and he has visions, and he sees differently from this point on. He fears the Lord, and he sees him sitting on a throne, high and lifted up. This aspect is very important because the fear here is the changing in his position, in his perspective. Man, he puts aside his own thoughts and his own ideas. He puts aside what is material, the values of this life. And Isaiah, he says, the year that King Uzziah died, his values from this life, they existed, they were very real, but now they are no longer sufficient for a ministry. So he makes a switch, he makes a change. When the king dies, it's like he baptized through the waters. There was a changing perspective. When he came up, it's like when you come off and your life changes. This is what happened. This is what happened in this verse. It's new life after this king died. It's life in the Holy Spirit, with the direction of the Holy Spirit in their lives. And from this moment on, he sees the glory of God. He sees the emotions. He feels the emotions. And he is doing now what the Lord wants him to do. And the will of the Lord wasn't for him to be all high and mighty and to be upon a big golden carriage and to be shown off. And he recognized this. The ministry, the life of the pastor, of the worker, the deacon, those who want to be pastors, whoever desires and wishes for this, have to seek the Lord. Ministry is more than life, is greater than life. You see how the king, he died. Man dies. The life that in Isaiah, the life that he now lives, he doesn't live through the flesh, but he lives through the Holy Spirit. We live now with the direction of the Holy Spirit leading us and guiding us in our lives. Very well, brethren. Now let's go to the second fundamental characteristic of a responsible ministry. The first was fear of the Lord. We're going to now look for another fundamental characteristic. There were two or three that we're going to be discussing today. Surely there's much more that we can find in the verses. We're going to be speaking of two or three. And in the second characteristic, we can find in verse 2. The verse states, above it stood seraphim. Each one had six wings. With two he covered his face, with two he covered his feet, and with two he flew. And here the brethren can find another characteristic that symbolizes and makes for a responsible ministry. What do we think the characteristic is based on the second verse? Look at the position of the seraphim. They had six wings. And why did two cover his face? Why did two cover his feet? That's where the detail is. He could have done other things with his wings. It could have been covering other things, but why does the Bible explicitly state that it was covering his face and his feet? Because all of the glory and honor has to be given to Christ. Who has to be seen? The Lord. In the verse, we see that Isaiah understood, he had the discernment. That flesh had to die, man had to die. And he starts to understand what is spiritual. He learns and he understands that the ministry is with humbleness, it's with your posture, it's with your position spiritually. It's humbleness. And the answer for this second question, therefore, is discernment and humility, humbleness. What he learned here is that discernment, humility, humbleness, even the angels before the Lord, if even they cover their faces, cover their feet for the glory of honor to be shown, then we should be doing the same thing. Isaiah, he understood this. He noticed how the angels covered their faces, covered their feet. When they covered their faces, they were showing a position of reverence before the Lord. And covering their feet, they were showing how our walk in this world, man's walk with Christ, has to be separated from the world. We have to completely separate these two things. The wings covering the feet is exactly that. It's man separating themselves from the world so they can walk with Christ through the Holy Spirit, separated from the things of this world. We have to turn off the things of this world and have fellowship and total fellowship with the Lord. And that is why the second and third characteristics is discernment, humility, humbleness. I'd like to make a small comment. When our brother mentioned previously that the prophet, he set aside what was man and what was flesh in order to see the glory and honor of God. And this shows how we have to behave before the Lord. Those who are before the Lord behave in this way. The seraphims, they were angels. And even the angels were reverent and showed reverence to the Lord. They were careful and they had care. And they noticed who they were before. And this was their behavior. The government, the ministry is not for man. It's not for us. It's for the Holy Spirit. Even the angels were in this path and being guided by the Holy Spirit. And we're going to learn what is the function of the seraphims, what type of angels they are. We're not going to learn about this right now, but just their humbleness and their reverence. They're not trying to show off. They're not trying to show that they're angels. They have six wings. And we shouldn't feel the need to show off either anything, our clothes, our hair. And if we try, then we're going to be punished or taken away from positions of leadership and have no place in the ministry of the Lord. No one should be showing off. No one should be trying to make themselves appear big. This is not what we are here for. We shouldn't even be trying to show off ourselves, our faces. There's no place for that in the ministry of the Lord. The only room is for the Holy Spirit. Man, the angels, even they recognize that they weren't Jesus. They aren't the ones that are going to come and save the world. They're not the ones that are going to lead the world in the rapture. Man has to recognize this as well. We cannot let our own confidence, self-worth, be greater than the Holy Spirit's project in our life. We have to learn to fear the Lord and to be humble before his face. And the wings covering the angel's feet represent the man who is strong in the path of the Lord, who is firm in his path and his walk with Christ. The cherubims and the seraphims, they recognized that they weren't greater than God. They were humble. They covered their faces. They covered their feet. Ministry has to be independent. When they start to be independent, they put their feet on the floor, it's over. This doesn't exist in our midst. We can't try to be in this world. We have to be separated from this world. Two of the wings allowed the angels to fly. With two wings, he flew. If we're not trying to go up, if the wings aren't bringing us up, ascending us into heaven, there's no gifts, there's no visitors in the church, there's no humility, there's no humbleness, there's no understanding of the word of the Lord. The ministry has to be within the Holy Spirit, has to be in the direction of the Holy Spirit. And the wings has to take the church higher. The wings that allow the angels to fly are the same ones that allow the church to be on the same level as the Holy Spirit, to be guided by the Holy Spirit. Revelations, spiritual things, this is what matters. Things that come from above. They only come from above. Comes from heaven and reaches us through the Holy Spirit. So the suggestion, brethren, for the message for tonight, we are suggesting Isaiah 6, 1, the verse that says, "In the year that the king Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on the throne, high and lifted up, and the train of his robe filled the temple." And how the aspects of the king dying, and how this allowed Isaiah to fear the Lord and to change his perspective. And I'd like to finalize again by greeting the brethren again with the peace of the Lord. The children have a song. Let us end our service now. One of the deacons may pray for the children, intermediates, adolescents. Lord Jesus, we plead for the power that's in your blood. We ask, Lord, that you can be extending your hands over your children, over your intermediates, adolescents. Protect them, Lord, each and every day from the offerings and from the bad things of this world. Lord, protect them in your blood. We know there is power. Lord, bless the teachers. Give them grace, authority to the parents as well. Give them patience, the authority and the wisdom to raise them in your presence. Protect them from the sicknesses and diseases, Lord, we pray in the name of Jesus, amen. Lord Jesus, we pull before your throne of grace, Lord, the service of this morning. Lord, prepare us for tonight and for the church tonight. And for us to understand, Lord, and to take in, Lord, all the teachings, we ask, we pray in the name of Jesus, amen. And in your name, Lord, we pray the grace of Jesus Christ, your love and eternal consolations of the Holy Spirit be poured on the church now and forever. Amen. Service is now completed. To all, a peace of the Lord.